Welcome to this episode of DIY3DTech.com. In this episode, we're going to take a look at this Thingiverse find I came across. So as I was cleaning up the pegboards, which I'm a big fan of, I noticed that my larger set of calipers were just kind of hanging loosely on the pegboard and just the metal clip. And they were rather, not super expensive calipers, but I wanted something a little bit nicer. And one of the issues was the thumb wheel on it. And what kind of caught my attention was this. And this flat blue developed this interesting design which offsets the thumb wheel, and so it holds the calipers nicely on the pegboards. I thought this is pretty interesting. I also like the idea of experimenting with a pegboard build, if you will. So I haven't done any pegboard type objects, so I figured this was a good one to experiment with, and figured I would share that with you folks. So anyways, let's take a deeper look. Let's go ahead, let's print this out and see what this looks like. So we're going to cut to a time lapse, and then we're going to come back and we're going to take a look at it hanging on the pegboard, see if it really does work and it lives up to its claim. So let's head over to the time lapse. One of the pieces is we're watching the time lapse in the upper corner. I wanted to share, it's a little bit about this design, so this isn't clear when we really look at it on Thingiverse. However, what I want to call your attention to is this pad down here that Flat Blue has added to kind of push it back up off the pegboard. Now, this is an interesting little addition because one of the things is these pegs, connect with the pegboard. I don't know if you guys have noticed, but if you're a pegboard fan, things like to lean forward. So this actually pushes it out to prevent it from leaning forward, if you will, and pulling downward on these pegs. So neat little addition, just something I think worth noting if you're looking to design your own pegboard type product. And I actually think I'll kind of borrow this. However, the one piece I don't quite understand is why there's this extra offset. So I understand this little bump out. However, this piece, this flat piece here, is kind of interesting. I'm not sure quite why he added that in. I would probably just, have that part flush and have it actually a little bit thicker. I'm thinking, part of the reason is you kind of want a little bit more beef where these pins join the material, and this piece is just simply a little bit too thin. So I'm not sure what the logic is there, why he just didn't kick it out the full length. And I think if I borrow this design for other things, I would kick this out a little bit further just to make it one big solid piece, because it's not going to use a ton more plastic. So I'm not sure of the design. And then also why this piece up here, I'm really not understanding, why that's sort of clipped off. But anyways, interesting design. Kind of want to share those pieces as it was printing. And, because part of the idea is here to kind of take a look at this in the Thingiverse finds to see how it was designed and how it could maybe be made better, or maybe some of the tips and tricks they used in creating the 3D structure. So anyways, let's cut over to the workbench and see how this thing looks all done. So here we are back in the shop. Now, this is how I used to hang my or at least this particular set of calipers on the pegboard. However, now with this printed out, what I simply do is slide it in here, and beautiful offset for the thumb wheel, so it sits nice and flush against the board, so it doesn't sit cockeyed. It holds it very nice, so very happy with this. Now, one of the things that I do want to share, when I took this off the printer, I cleaned up the supports because the pins on the back have supports with them. And then what I had to do is heat it up with my heat gun to spread the pins just enough to fit in the pegs. They were just a little bit short, like, 0.2 or 3 millimeters. So by warming them up with the heat gun, they spread out. And also it allowed it to slide into the board much easier than I let it cool before putting the calipers in. And, now it's a perfect fit. So I don't know how this will be to take out. If I try to take it out, I think it'll be pretty difficult, and I might actually risk breaking it. I guess not. So there's what it looks like on the back side. Again, I need to clean this up a little bit more, actually.
The battery died in my handheld grinder before I finished it up. However, again, these two had to be moved just a little bit apart, and these, the base was a, this bottom piece where the two intersect was a little bit too big to fit in, but when I heated it up with the heat gun, it just slid right in, and as you can see, fit very nicely. So I'm pretty happy with this print. This does a very nice job. So anyways, hey, I give it a thumbs up. If you found this video interesting, and if you got a pegboard and calibers, I would highly recommend it. I'll put the link to it below in Thingiverse. And hey, like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.
Please click like below and subscribe to the channel to keep up to date on all of our projects.